Welcome back to our amazing exploration of the Orion's Arm Universe project. Earth is probably the most notable garden world in the Terrigen Sphere, but did you know that its nearby neighbor, the planet of Venus, could have had a similar fate? Up until 700 million years ago, it was an ocean world like Earth. However, a runaway greenhouse effect cursed it to become a hot, inhospitable world with a noxious, crushing atmosphere. In the BT centuries, many theorized about Venus being a jungle world underneath all those bright, fluffy clouds. But when they sent probes, all they found was a deadly environment akin to hell. Because of this, Venus was often overlooked as a target for early exploration missions. In the early interplanetary age, a small research base was set up in orbit around Venus. The thick atmosphere was mined for carbon dioxide and then shipped off to Luna and other locations across Solstice, along with manufacturing materials made out of carbon. Power collection swarms were set up at the L1, L4, and L5 points of Venus. Bubble halves were also built in Venus's atmosphere. However, during the technocalypse, Venus was abandoned due to nano outbreaks. After the technocalypse, Venus began to be recolonized. Aten asteroids were sent into Venus orbit to try to terraform the planet. However, the terraformation project failed, and an orbital ring was constructed instead. To survive deeper in Venus's atmosphere, treks began to modify themselves to survive higher temperatures and pressures. This allowed halves to be lower in the atmosphere, allowing them to attach to each other easy. Vex also began to inhabit the surface. Eventually, there was a war between the lower halves and the upper halves. The lower halves won, but they were disliked by the rest of Solstice and had to flee. Later on, the To'uls traveled to Venus, and To'ul tweaks were modified to live on the surface of Venus. New balloon habitats that encircled the globe were constructed, along with floating wind turbines and atmospheric mines. Gaia also created a monitoring system to watch over Venus. In 8977 AT, the inhabitants of Venus finally decided to start terraformation. Technology would finally free Venus from its hellish curse after all these millions of years. The terraformation would use many ingenious processes. First, a giant sunshade at the Venus L1 point would be constructed to cool the planet. It would also protect Venus from harmful solar radiation. Radiator fins were put into Venus's atmosphere to help radiate Venus's heat into space. The surface population was evacuated, and comets were sent to bring water to Venus. A temporary debris ring was also formed around Venus using excess carbon. It would later be turned into an orbital band called the diadem, which would contain thousands of habitats and combustorium nodes. After that, water created using hydrogen from the sun and aldebaran were imported onto the planetary surface. Limestone rocks, algae, and other microbial plants were sent in to sequester the carbon dioxide. And finally, a ring of 7 statite mirrors were placed behind Venus in order to reflect light and simulate a 24-hour day and night cycle. The whole planet shares the same day-night cycle, and light is simply redirected during the nighttime. By the year 10,000 AT, the terraformation was complete, and the surface population has now reached 2 billion. However, the majority of the population of Venus lives in the orbital ring, along with the ruling S2 AI named Encyclopedia. The whole planet is also governed by the Venus Governing Authority, which is associated with the Solstice organization. There is also a Bernal Sphere called New Jafar, where the remaining To'uls live. The total population of Venus, including the orbital population, is around 117 billion. The Lagrange points of Venus are also heavily inhabited. The L2 point is home to an old Computronium swarm with a population of 1.5 trillion. The L4 point is home to the Demeter swarm, a swarm of hedonistic habitats. The L5 point is home to many habitats and Computronium nodes that 10 billion call home. And at the L3 point, there is a station that is part of the Beam Rider network. Overall, Venus and its nearby habitats are very interesting places, and we hope you like this exploration of them. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.